In his brief history of decay, Emil Cioran, the Romanian nihilist philosopher, was 100% right when he wrote that since society was constituted, anybody who tried to withdraw from it was either persecuted or mocked. The only thing that would, the only thing that would not be forgiven is if you withdraw from society. Like, anything would be forgiven as long as you had some kind of trade, some kind of subtitle under your name. Like, if you have as many degrees as a thermometer or, you know, as many letters as the alphabet next to your name, like, then you can be forgiven anything. As long as you have, he writes, a seal on your nothingness. What a phrase, right? That packs a potent punch. As long as, that's pithy, as long as you have a seal on your nothingness. The point is that as people raise on the hierarchical ladder rungs of societal sort of upward mobility, the fact of the matter is people think, oh, wow, you're so impressive because you have this degree, or you're so impressive because you're the CEO of this company, or you're so impressive because you have this trade, or you're so impressive because you have this subtitle under your name. That is nothing more than a seal on your nothingness. Like, that's all that it is. Society was constituted in such a way as to persecute or mock anybody who went against it. You will be forced to drink the hemlock. You will be called a corrupter of the youth and teaching ways contrary to the gods. So what I want to tell you is this is one of the things that I love about cats. They do not care at all about society. Like, when they're playing with their mouse, for example, they're not worried about what you think about. They're not worried about what you think about them at the moment. They're not tormenting the mouse because they're not capable of empathy, although they will sit with you when sick and show incredible kindness and attachment to their owner, although I don't like to call humans owners at all. I would say they're a roommate. But because they don't have empathy, that means they're not capable of cruelty either. And the fact is they've been they're not cruel. They're just playing with their mouse. One poet argued that he was just giving it time to escape his prey because it's a predator. That's what a cat is. But the reason why cats have been demonized so much throughout history, according to one philosopher, John Gray, in his book, The Philosophy of Cats, he argues, and this is wild stuff, that the reason why cats have been demonized, like Descartes threw a cat out of a window, religious people were burning cats because, and this is horrible, chasing, burning, torturing cats as part of the witch hunt. Like, oh, they're associated with the occult and witches. And that's what happened with cats. Like, they have been demonized and so poorly treated by religious people throughout the centuries. And the reason John Gray argues this is why this happened is because a cat is so unlike a human. A cat has alien contentment. What a phrase again, like alien contentment. They have a contentment, the ability to just be content. Like, they don't need you, but they happen to love you, you know, which God knows why, but be that as it may, like they have this alien contentment that we as humans always trying to climb the ladder of hierarchical upper mobility, not working territorially, as Stephen Pressfield said, just for our graph, but hierarchically trying to impress people we don't even care about. Like Marcus Aurelius said, how amazing is it that we love ourselves more than we love anybody else, but we care about what others think more than we care about our own opinion of us? How strange is that? It's strange to be astonished at anything, and it's strange to care about what anybody thinks when we love ourselves more than we love anybody else. But at any rate, and in any event, what the thing that cats have is they're not trying to climb hierarchically, and so they don't have an alpha. That's why cats don't obey you. Dogs do, because dogs have an alpha, but cats don't have an alpha in the pack. So a cat is content, and because of that, people have been jealous and had envy of cats and therefore demonized them because and the Egyptians worshiped them as gods because they understood their supremacy, but so many other cultures and religious people have persecuted cats, and it's actually a tragic thing. But Nietzsche argued that envy is actually a good thing because it helps you to be more driven. And in the same way, instead of envying cats their contentment or wrongly demonizing them for misunderstanding their personality, which is just a word made up by psychiatry and it's a Jungian idea, I want to be somebody who sees cats as an inspiration to be more content by living in the stillness. Okay, I think that's potent. And by the way, I want to come up with new ideas, and that's why I'm trying to combine things and then come up with my own solutions, building on, like Einstein did, the Lorentz principle, to come up with the general special theories of relativity. I want to give you original ideas because those are the ones that are going to be remembered. I don't want to be a carbon copy of anybody. I want to come up with original ideas. That's something I'm very passionate about. But I want to see the envy of Nietzsche cause us as humans to achieve or drive for the contentment of cats. I've never heard anybody do that before, but I believe that that's a good way to live your life. Cats don't care about society in the way that humans do because it's a seal on your nothingness. Now, if you have a specific thing you want to accomplish or a dream that you have to make a difference and to be different, to not fit in but to stand out, fantastic. But if you're just trying to get a seal on your nothingness by having a subtitle under your name, what is the point? Society rightfully mocks and persecutes whoever tries to withdraw from it because society subsumes you in an overarching grayness. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. So here's what I want to say as I close. I was studying Plato and Socrates talking to Glaucon today in the context of the allegory of the cave, but what he talked about was interesting. He and Glaucon were having a discussion about this, but he talked about how an excess of liberty leads to an excess of slavery. So Nietzsche, for example, argued that only if your heart is in fetters can your spirit be free. And it's hard for you to understand that unless you've experienced it. In other words, if you're not disciplined and a master over yourself, you're going to be mastered by other things. And to will is just to overcome any sort of emotion is a will of another emotion. So as soon as you understand that your spirit will only be free when your heart is in fetters, you're going to have discipline, and discipline and self-mastery leads to freedom. And that's on a microcosmic level, but on a macro level, that's the same reason tyranny derives itself from democracy. Tyranny is led forth by democracy, because out of democracy comes tyranny, because as individuals, if we have too much liberty, it leads to slavery. And that's why he talked about you have an excess of flesh and you don't have the sunburnt skin of a warrior, and therefore the people are going to realize you're only rich because no one's dared to challenge you. As he talked about oligarchy, etc. What I want to argue is as I wrap the bow here, is this ideal that you do not have to be somebody who is a slave to your own passions. You do not have to be mastered by your dreams. You don't have to be somebody who is dictated by society. You can say, I'm going to be my own person. And if I'm persecuted or mocked for it, at least I'm original. Like, don't be unoriginal at all costs. Don't be an original. Don't be an original. It's taught in our society today that men should be effeminate. Like, that's a major message. Now, I have many gay friends. And I love these friends. They're super fun and interesting people, and I'm very, very tight with them. But some of them, like, are against the LGBTQ movement. I have one gay friend who's incredibly masculine. So when I talk about being effeminate or not, it has nothing to do with whether people are gay or not. That's literally not what I'm talking about. I'm saying no matter who you are as a male, like, as we are losing genders in our culture, now I don't want to talk about pronouns or anything like that. That just doesn't interest me. It's not perennial. What I want to say is this. If we no longer are allowed to be a man as a man, like, what happens is we become so vulnerable, so transparent, so emotionally available that we lose our masculinity, and it's like the lost generation that would lose its man parts in the war and therefore didn't want to go to battle and became jaded and postmodernist. So what I want to say, I know I've said that so many times. Sorry to be a bit recursive, but I will argue and really want to hold forth that it's time to, like, go against society and say, I'm going to be anti-establishment and I'm going to be a man. I'm not going to be emotionally available because that doesn't help anybody. I'm going to go back to what people were doing in medieval times, and I'm going to be a warrior. I'm going to be a man. I'm going to be stoical. I'm going to be logical. I'm going to be philosophical. I'm going to have equanimity, equilibrium. People aren't going to be able to cause me to be anything other than cool, calm, and collected. Like, that is the way to think and live your life. You don't have to be effeminate. You don't have to be emotionally available. You don't have to be vulnerable. You don't have to be emotionally transparent. You can be strong, because guess what? Emotions are fleeting. They're not perennial. They pass anyway. So because they're effervescent, because they're constantly leaving, I should say evanescent, then you, like, by splurting out your emotions as an emo bleeding heart, what's that going to solve? Instead, be strong. Go against society. Don't have a seal on your nothingness. You don't need a subtitle under your name. If you're going to be mocked by society for withdrawing from it, so what? Be somebody who is anything other than unoriginal. Be original. Be original. Be original. And do not be afraid to go against society. If you're a guy listening to this, be a man. Put yourself like a soldier and go to war.